Hello, 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 everyone. My name is Tamar Smithers. I am Director of Education and Public Programs for the National Museum of African American Music that's set to open in downtown Nashville, Tennessee this September 2020. Our mission is to educate the world, preserve the legacy, and celebrate the central role that African Americans play in creating the American soundtrack. We thank you so much for joining us today for our Youth Thursday while we present our From Nothing to Something program. This program is usually a series of one-hour workshops that we take into the school district, community venues, and spaces like that. It's geared towards students in grades K through 8. But it's really appropriate for all ages. And what we do is we teach how African Americans and how enslaved Africans, when they came over here to this country, had to be very innovative in creating music. Because when they came, they didn't have their instruments with them. They only had what they could bring through their memory. So creating something from nothing. Today we have one of our units today called the Spoons. We hope that you all will be able to join us and play the spoons. So if you have a couple seconds, run and grab two spoons and get ready because you're going to be some spoons musicians today, all right? So once again, we thank you for joining us today. We're so excited that you're joining us. Like I said, this is a program that will teach about how people use inexpensive household items to create music. So I'm going to go ahead and give you just a little bit of historical context of the spoons. So the spoons can be traced from Africa to Europe to the Middle East. Playing the spoons is one of the oldest forms of creating music. In fact, prehistoric rock drawings show dancing figures with curved blades like spoons in their hands. Ancient Egyptians, Greeks, and Romans all played a form of the spoons. The tradition of playing spoons is thought to have begun with playing the bones, which is a technique in which music was created when two rib bones from a sheep or similar animal were struck together. In America, spoons were played extensively through the 1800s, especially in the areas of Memphis, Tennessee, Louisville, Kentucky, Ohio, and the Mississippi River valleys. In these areas, spoons were widely used as musical instruments because they were inexpensive household items that could easily be obtained by people who had little money and who lived in periods of oppression. During the 1890s through the Great Depression, the playing of spoons mainly occurred with jug bands. These bands made use of everyday objects like washboards, jugs, wash tubs, and spoons to make music. In American blues music, spoons were often called the bones, the clappers, or the clackers. Can y'all repeat after me? Bones, clappers, clackers. All right, keep that in mind because we'll test it a little bit later. Spoons for playing could be wood or metal, but blues musicians generally use the metal spoons. That was what their preferred spoons playing was. Today, playing the spoons is coming back through the popularity of spoon festivals, jug band festivals, and traditional folk music festivals held globally all around the world. When we think of the spoons, we know that there are different instrument classifications. So we have strings, we have woodwind, but we also have percussion. And so when we think of the spoons belong in the percussion instrument classification. When we're thinking of different musical genres that have been influenced by the spoon, you really can think of anything from gospel to blues, jazz, rock, folk music. Really, the spoons, anything that has a rhythm, you can play the spoons to it. Some notable musicians are James Hardy, John Preacher Stevenson, artists the Spoonman, Sam Spoons, and Dev Spoons Perry, but one of my favorites, who we have the pleasure of having here today, is Mr. Lucius Spoonman Talley. Can we give him a round of applause, y'all? Mr. Talley is a native Nashvillian who learned to play the spoons through the late Bobby Hebb, who played spoons with Grand Ole Opry star Roy Acuff. Mr. Talley is a former drummer who has played with many notable musicians, and he also plays various woodwind instruments. Mr. Talley's spoon playing has led him to perform for America's Got Talent, acting of the hit TV show Nashville, and performing in various commercials. Can y'all help me give a round of applause from wherever you're at around the world for Mr. Spoonman Talley?
Thank you. Thank you. Do they do? Do they don't stop the rock and roll, baby?
Talley, can you talk a little bit about how the sound is different when you switch from the metal to the plastic spoons?
Well, boys and girls, ladies and gentlemen, the spoons are just like any other instrument. On the keyboard, you have all the black and white keys. You have C, D, E, F, G, A, B, C. Clarinet, saxophone, trumpet, bass, spoons. I tune my spoons this way. Everywhere I hit, it's just like playing an instrument. It's a different note. C, D, E, F, G, A, B, C. On the leg, it's a different note. Between, different note. Jaw, different note. And that's the way we play spoons. Now, spoons are one of the easiest and cheapest instrument that you can play and buy. Everyone has household spoons. Mm-hmm. And boys and girls, while you're out of school, go get your spoon.
Get your spoons.
We gonna play spoons today. And you know what? After you get through watching me, you're gonna start out just like you would at school in the first grade. When you learn how to put them together, I'm gonna bring you on up to the second or third grade.
Ooh.
When you get them in your hand without dropping them, I'm gonna carry you to the sixth grade. Then I'm going to skip you and carry you to the ninth grade.
All right.
And you know, when you get through in 5 minutes, you will be you will be able to play spoon. All you have to do is just put them together and be able to count. Like most of your songs, say the song is in 4-4 time. Everyone can count. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. Now, that's the basic. You take them, whether you're left-handed or right-handed, you want to put them back to back.
Back to back. You all got
back
your spoons?
Back to back.
Let's try this.
Back to back, and put one finger between, and go all the way down to the end where you get a good grip. The most important thing is not to drop them. If you could put them back to back, when I'm in schools, we pass out these type, which is plastic, and you put them back to back, put one finger between, and on my count, 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. Now, if you can do that, you're on your way. And just practice anywhere you hit on your body. 1, 2, 3, 4. Now, some of you out in the audience have regular kitchen spoons, and you can hurt yourself. So what I'm going to show you is when you try to play them, if you're playing them in your hand, in the center, in the palm, on the outside of your arm, no, this is a no-no on the inside. No-no around the knees.
Now why, now I'm sorry, Mr. Talley, why is that not good to play on those particular spots?
Well, they are very tender. And in my spoon playing, I have had 2 accidents.
Oh, no.
I had one on the knee where I had to go to the emergency room. And the other one, I hit a vein. And one hand swole up the size of 2 hands. So you have to be very careful, boys and girls, in playing the spoons. Other than that, you're safe. And my teacher who taught me, the late, great Bobby Hebb, he always taught me the different sounds, and one of the things that he taught me right now today, I haven't been able to do it, is to play on the side of my jaws.
Ooh.
But he could play all over his head.
Wow.
That was my idol, Mr. Bobby Hebb.
All right. Mm-hmm. All right, so do you think that they're ready? I think they're ready. You guys got your spoons?
Are y'all ready?
Okay.
I'm going to go through one more time. One more time.
And then we're going to play together.
And we're going to play together. And you're going to have fun while you're on this lockdown. You have learned how to play the spoons. Put them together.
Back
Remember,
to back.
Back to back. And we're going to show you.
Ready? All right. Now, everyone watch Mr. Talley because he's our director. He's our conductor, okay? So we are musicians. We're getting ready. We're sitting up straight. And we're watching Mr. Talley for our cue.
Ready?
Go ahead, Jeremiah.
Aww.
I see you.
All right, you guys sound amazing. Yes, we can hear you from here. You guys are all now spoons musicians. Would you say that, Mr. Talley?
Oh, yes.
All right.
You ready? Now what you do when you're not doing anything, practice. Practice makes perfect.
Mm-hmm.
And don't try to do what all you see me do at the beginning. It takes a few years to get to that level. But right now, you're in junior high school. You're getting there. You're getting closer. And each day, oh, and let me, with spoons, it can fit in with the music of your choice. I play it with gospel, blues, rock and roll, jazz, any type of music with a beat you can fit in. If they have drums, any percussion, you can fit in.
All right. All right. Well, you know what? We have a couple minutes. Would you like to do one more song?
That'd be fine.
All right. And then we'll do some questions.
Okay, that'll be fine.
All right.
I'm going to use the plastic.
So this is what we call bluegrass. A little bit faster. Questions, because I'm sure all of our audience members have some questions, but I'm just trying to pull some of the questions that we normally get when we're out in the field doing this work in the schools and in the community venues. So you mentioned something earlier that, you know, if you're a young aspiring musician, you know, if you're in the third grade or even the eighth grade or even older, the first time you pick up the spoons, you're not going to be able to do everything that you did, right?
That's correct.
So can you talk a little bit about how, first of all, how old were you when you first started? And then how important it is to continue to practice, because practice makes perfect, right?
Well, I'd have forgot the age, but I never could get it down. My good friend, Bobby Hebb, was playing on the city buses here, on the Jefferson Street bus. His mother and father was playing guitar, and he was tap dancing, playing the spoons. So he was from South Nashville, I was from North Nashville. I didn't meet Bobby until high school. But I tried and tried and tried, but I never could get it down. So when I met Bobby, it's a funny story. When I met him in high school, he was playing trumpet and I was playing clarinet. And when the band would go on trips to follow the football team in high school, Bobby would pull his spoons out and play them on the bus, and we laughed, cut up. And I began to learn a little bit at a time at the age of 14 or 15 in high school. Then later on, I became a drummer, and he became a guitar player. And We played all the clubs in the city of Nashville, and Bobby really expressed himself. We had shows down in Printer's Alley, and Bobby would tap dance and play spoons. And it just, ooh, it just blew my mind. Mm-hmm. I wanted to learn how to do this. So finally, Bobby went in the Navy. I went in the Air Force. We got out about the same time. We put a combo together, and we started playing. And then he got a call from Mickey and Sylvia. They had a hit record out called Love is Strange. Mm-hmm. Mickey decided to buy a nightclub in New York, and he wanted somebody to tour and play with his wife, and they selected Bobby. Instead of Mick and Sylvia, it become Bobby and Sylvia. Mm-hmm. And they named the nightclub in New York Sylvia's Blue Morocco. Mm. And they needed a drummer. Bobby sent for me. And that was history.
It was history. History was made.
And I picked it up. And one thing I found out about it, I test the water. And one day I called Bobby, and I said, Bobby, you know what? I said, I got it down now. And he said, you know, it's a lost art. He said, I wanted one of my family members to pick it up, but they didn't. So over the telephone, I laid it down and let him hear me play. And he told me, like I'm telling you kids, the first grade, he said, you're on your way. And he said, you're not quite there. He said, you done finished high school with it. He said, but I'm going to give you some more lessons. Mm. And he said, I tell you another fella that's right in Nashville, and he's playing gigs with you. He can play them a little bit. And his name was Eddie Taylor. They call him Eddie Taps Taylor. And we all got together and learned how to play them all over our body. Mm. And I got to traveling, and one day I was on a cruise ship, and yes. My pastor said he have a talent show. And I went down and applied for the talent show on the cruise ship. Had an outstanding band on the cruise ship. And I selected a song, Let's Groove, by Earth, Wind, and Fire. And I never have been out in front of an audience, and they selected me. They only selected 10 guests on the ship.
Wow.
And they made me number 10. Wow. So playing music, I know if you're the last act, you got to clean it up.
Sure do. Come with it.
I got down there, and I never been out front. When I'm playing drums, nobody can see me. I hide behind the cymbals.
Right.
Because I'm scared. I'm shy. The butterflies eat me up. So I got up there when they cranked up. I got so scared and so nervous that I almost dropped the spoon. I got the video at home. But I finally adjusted. And when that crowd on that ship, it seemed like it was on a Saturday night. Looked like everyone was there. And by 7-day cruise, everywhere I went on that ship, they was calling me Spoonman. They wanted to know if it was real spoons.
You were famous, huh?
So I started doing research on it. And when I did research on it, I said, well, it is a lost art. I said, when I get back to the States, I'm going to try it out. And I said, the first boo I get, I'm quitting. Mm. I'm putting them down. And I never got any boos. Everybody seemed to like. And when the churches opened up, one church after another all over the city here was calling me. Then I went as far away at my pastor's father's church in El Paso, Texas. Mm-hmm. And I got a video of that performance too. And in El Paso, Texas, they welcomed me. Then it come up, they had a senior citizen contest at the Ryman Auditorium here in Nashville, and it was a $5,000 prize. And the judges was Brenda Lee, Dobie Gray.
Shout out to Brenda Lee.
uh, Caledemus, Channel 4. She was one of the judges, and the lady that owned the Bluebird Cafe. Well, anyway, Billy Block Band, and I told him I could put spoons with anything, and I played, and I didn't win the $5,000. I won the third place, $500, and that crowd in Ramonata Torin, that led me on further. Then I began to get gigs all over the city with playing spoons. I did the CMA one year at the hotel, the Omni Hotel, doing the CMAs. And
it led you to doing stuff on television, right?
Right, television.
Commercials.
And so, on television, I played spoons with an artist named Bradley Gilbert. And the last time I looked, it was about 13 million views. It was a video for Bradley Gilbert, and they made a service station. I was doing acting then. They had a service station set up for me, and I run the gas pumps, and about 12 motorcycles come down to gas up, and I played spoons in the video.
Wow.
I took my spoons out and played video.
So playing these spoons have really opened up so many opportunities and so many doors for you.
So many doors.
That is so awesome. Well, we are going to go ahead and wrap up today. Thank you so much, Mr.
You're
Talley.
Quite
Can
well.
We give Mr. Talley a round of applause from where we're at? Another one.
Thank you.
I know you guys had so much fun. Remember to teach all your friends, your family, and practice makes perfect. You know, this is something that you find in the house. Two spoons, you can make some music and create some music. You can create something from nothing. So once again, we want to thank you for joining us today for our From Nothing to Something workshop. And we ask you to continue to stay tuned with us on all of our social media platforms, Facebook, Instagram, Twitter. Every Thursday at the noontime hour, we will have our Youth Thursday. So we'll have some type of youth programming going on. If you want more information on the programs and events that we're doing, you can follow us, like I said, on our Instagram, Facebook, Twitter, but you can also go to our website at www.blackmusicmuseum.org. And remember, we're open in September 2020, so we hope that you get your tickets and we hope that you come on down. Take care, everybody. Thank you so much.